wearing your sunglasses. Hey guys, so to continue my Charlotte bucket list, I'm eating more food. And I am at Amelie's right now, and it's a French bakery that's open 24/7. This one is the original one, which is in North Davidson, or the NoDa section of Charlotte. And since I didn't want to go alone, I brought this dime piece. This is Rebecca, and she's been my best friend since high school, and we're still best friends, and she goes to USC with me. So she's going to try some stuff with us. Anything to say?
I'm so excited.
Such an honor to be here.
I got stuff for the whole fam. I got 2 salted caramel brownies, 2 raspberry almond tea cakes, a chocolate mini mousse cup, a raspberry macaroon, and a dark chocolate cinnamon
macaroon.
Exciting.
Oh, yeah.
I got a passion fruit mousse cup. It's kind of hard to hold on. It's a little bit hard to see. But it's kind of like bright yellowish almost, and it's in like a chocolate cup. And I also got, oh, there's hair. Okay. I also got a pistachio macaroon, a basil lime macaroon, and a pineapple caramel macaroon. And I haven't had any of those before, so that should be interesting. And I'll let you guys know what we think. Okay, so we just sampled all of our stuff, and it was like, I was pleasantly surprised because I've never gotten any of these before. I've definitely been to Amelie's before, and obviously it's a definite go because it's such a unique experience, and it's like, it's got a lot of like cool interior designs, and it's just like every single store that you go into, it's very different. But I haven't had any of these flavors before, and they're all like very unique. So my favorite one is definitely the passion fruit run. That was a really surprising flavor. It was super fresh and fruity, and the chocolate, I'm pretty sure it was dark chocolate, was like an awesome contrast in like the tartness of the passion fruit. And then the pineapple caramel macaroon was pretty good, except it didn't have like too much of a flavor. It was just kind of like there. The pistachio one was also pretty good, but this one, kind of like the pineapple one, didn't have too much of a flavor, but like it was a hint more of pistachio, obviously. But then the basil lime one was really surprising because neither Rebecca or I thought that this would be good because basil and lime just didn't sound that appealing. But this was by far the best one because it had a lot of flavor. Like you can taste the basil and you can taste the lime, and it was just like, I wouldn't say aggressive, but like you could definitely taste the flavor, and I thought it was really good. And Rebecca let me have some of her caramel brownie, and I'm amazed that I haven't had it before because it's so good.
What were your thoughts? Always a go-to, the salted caramel brownie, and then I'm a big fan of the cinnamon chocolate macaroon.
Oh.
Second time I've had it. And then the tea cake's really good too.
Good review.
Thank you. I am back and in my room, obviously. Today was super fun. I haven't had a lot of time to get to hang out with Rebecca, so it was really cool to get to see her again. And Amelie's was amazing, as usual. That passion fruit mousse cup was absolutely unreal. And I definitely suggest going to get that if you do decide to go to Amelie's, because that is 100% something I would put on your bucket list for Charlotte. And the other footage that you saw was the NoDa area of Charlotte, or like the North Davidson area, and it honestly feels a lot smaller than I remember, and it wouldn't be like a huge attraction that I would put on your list, but it is something really cool that I would go and see if you're more of an artsy kind of person and like looking at galleries and different kinds of like shops and stuff that are kind of like more avant-garde or sort of out there. So that is something that it depends on the person if you want to add it to your book and add it onto your bucket list. But tonight was really cool, and one of the things that I did point out in the NoDa footage was the Cabo fish taco, and that has some of the best fish tacos that I've ever had. So I would definitely add that to your Charlotte bucket list if you are a fan of fish tacos. But yeah, tonight was really fun. I really enjoyed it. And if you also like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And hopefully I'll see you next week. Bye. Is this good?
It's a little close.
Okay.
Do you want me to take it for you?
No, it's okay. It's fine.
The blooper reel's gonna be too rude.
I hate it.